Earlier this week, I was asked on CNN to make sense of one more case in which Donald Trump had said something demonstrably false and then explained it away with a caustic tweet and an indignant interview. I replied that there was a pattern here and a term for a person who did this kind of thing, a bullshit artist. I was not using that label casually, and in case you have sensitive ears, I'm going to use it a few more times. Trump is many things, some of them dark and dangerous, but at his core, he is a BS artist. Harry Frankfurt, an eminent moral philosopher, wrote a brilliant essay in 1986 called On Bullshit. Frankfurt himself wrote about Trump in this vein in Time, as have Jeet Hur and Eldar Saralic. Frankfurt distinguishes crucially between lies and BS. Telling a lie is an act with a sharp focus. It is designed to insert a particular falsehood at a specific point. In order to invent a lie at all, the teller of a lie must think he knows what is true. But someone engaging in BS, Frankfurt explains, is neither on the side of the true nor on the side of the false. His eye is not on the facts at all. Frankfurt writes that the BSer's focus is panoramic rather than particular and has more spacious opportunities for improvisation, color, and imaginative play. This is less a matter of craft than of art, hence the familiar notion of the bullshit artist, he writes. This has been Donald Trump's mode all his life. He boasts and boasts and boasts about his business, his buildings, his books, his wives. Much of it is a concoction of hyperbole and falsehood. And when he's found out, he's like that guy we have all met making wild claims at the bar, who, when confronted with the truth, quickly responds, "I knew that." Take, for instance, the most extraordinary example, his non-relationship with Vladimir Putin. In May 2014, addressing the National Press Club, here's what Trump said.
I was in Russia. I was in Moscow recently, and I spoke indirectly and directly with President Putin, who could not have been nicer.
In November 2015, at a Fox debate, he said this of Putin.
And I got to know him very well because we were both on 60 Minutes.
Did Trump really believe that you can say something like that on live TV and no one would check? Did he think that no one would notice that the 60 Minutes show consisted of two separate pre-recorded interviews with Putin in Moscow and Trump in New York? By that logic, I have gotten to know Franklin Roosevelt very well because I've run some clips of him on my television show. In fact, it was just BS. Or look at the issue that fueled his political rise, birtherism. Trump claimed in 2011 that he had sent investigators to Hawaii and that, quote, they cannot believe what they're finding. For weeks, Trump continued to imply that there were huge findings to be released soon. He hinted to George Stephanopoulos, "We're going to see what happens." That was 5 years ago, in April 2011. Nothing happened. In fact, it appears highly unlikely that Trump ever even sent any investigators to Hawaii in the first place. In 2011, Salon asked Trump's spokesman, Michael Cohen, for any details about the investigators. Cohen explained that it was all very secret, naturally. Trump has said the same about his plans to defeat ISIS, which he can't reveal. He's boasted that he has a strategy to win solidly Democratic states this fall, but he won't reveal which ones. Even by Trump's standards, that one is a head-scratcher. Won't we notice when he campaigns in those states? Or will it be so secret that even the voters won't be told? Of course, it's really all just BS. Harry Frankfurt concludes that liars and truth-tellers are both acutely aware of facts and truth. The BS artist, however, has lost all connection with reality. By virtue of this, Frankfurt writes, bullshit is a greater enemy of truth than lies are. We see the consequences. As the crazy talk continues, standard rules of fact, truth, and reality have disappeared in this campaign. Donald Trump has piled such vast quantities of his trademark product into the political arena that the stench is now overwhelming and unbearable. For more, go to cnn.com/Fareed and read my Washington Post column this week.